Good evening, Toastmasters, guests. I think every one of you like public speaking, and you know how important it is to make pauses in public speaking. And I can tell you it is important not only for public speaking, but also for many other areas in life, and especially in painting. Let me explain what do I mean. Lines can talk. I can start with a very simple picture of this picture, and when you look at it, you can read this line. No, it's not necessary to switch the light. It's okay. You can look to these lines, and the lines are very monotone, and within these monotone lines, your eye become boring very soon because of simplicity of this picture. On the next slide, you can see the other picture, same picture, but with the different lines. Some lines are thicker with a high accent of the shape of this body. Some other lines are disappearing, going to the space of silence. However, that's not going to be a problem, because your brain construct the missing lines by yourself, and easily you become a constructor, you become a co-author of the painter, isn't it? That's a really interesting thing. The point is that you don't need to say too much, but enough. Look at the next picture. This is very expressive one, right? You don't see nose, you don't see many other details here. Andy Warhol creates this empty space of silence for you, for your imagination, for your, it's kind of breathing area, air for your brain, right? I think you got the idea. Let me explain the evolution of the silence in painting. Look at this picture. This is not photo, this is modern portrait. Look how many details we have. Every flower, every blade, eye, everything talk a lot. Every square meter talk to you, and talk a lot, and talk and talk and talk. And within this story, you don't have much space for you to think, because that's been everything been said already. Okay? On the next picture, you might say, maybe Korovin didn't finish this one. Look at the hands, wall, shirt, not much details. The main accent here he has for the face. That's the main attention. That's his story. Everything else is your space where you can imagine, where you can try your, you know, creativity. If you go to the next step further from realism to the more abstract direction, you can see this nice girl, and Modigliani here do not care about details. He pay attention only to eyes of this girl, only to the face, and he doesn't care about even anatomy. It's not so important. Everything else is in silent space. On the next step further, it is almost a symbol of silence, right? You can just imagine what dream this girl has, right? There's no much reality here. It's kind of dream. It's whole space of silence for your creativity, for your imagination here. On the next step further, it's going to be just a complete silence. Maybe not very comfortable, but for some people. Because when you sleep too deep, it can be looked as a death, right? hyperrealism and suprematism are the two extreme points on the scale of fine art, and lots of schools between them. But there's no right or wrong school. It's kind of day and light. During the day, we see lots of details. We see lots of lights. It's lots of information coming to us. And at night, we have silence, space for dream, space for imagination, and people who have tendency to have attractions here for the abstract art. Which means there's no right or wrong answers here. There's no right or wrong painting. Everything is possible, like day and light. And I would like you to expand your view on the fine art in terms of the silent space and enjoy your adventures in fine art. Thank you very much.